A man in California ordered a French onion soup on Easter, and he bit into it, and he bit into a condom. A used condom. The man took the condom to a criminological laboratory, and they found out that the condom had a female DNA on it. And the man was really upset about that. But the thing is, if there is female DNA on it, that means there automatically has to be a male DNA on it. So that's a double whammy. But of course, the man was raising concerns about the female DNA. I would have said, excuse me, sir, they got the man DNA on it. I don't mind the female DNA so much. I mean, that's still disgusting. But let's focus on the man DNA here. Of course, he did settle out of court with the Claim Jumper restaurant. That's the name of the fucking restaurant, is Claim Jumper. And they had a legal claim filed against it. That must happen a lot. They must have waiters putting condoms in all over the soups. Get a fucking name like that, Claim Jumper. Can't be called Claim Jumper and be surprised when someone jumps to you with a claim that you have done something wrong. You're basically asking for it. If I found a used condom in my French onion soup any other day of the week, I would be incredibly upset about that. But if it's on Easter, that's the resurrection of the Christ Lord. So that means that it's life, okay? It's a sign of life there. It's a celebration of life. You understand that? And what better sign and symbol of life than a used condom? I don't know why we bother with all this bunny business. I think a little better symbol would be the used condom, and then you could, on Easter, you could throw around used condoms all over the lawn. Hey, not even Easter, just do that every day. Have it be a year-long celebration. Have the children run out on the lawn trying to find the slippery snakes. That's fun for them, plus it's also fun for the adults who get to make the damn things. And that's a whole lot of fun there. I think Easter would skyrocket in popularity after that shit.
Jesus!